is a palpable feeling as you walk into Catholic schools of a welcoming atmosphere, of students understanding service and empathy, and what a relationship with each other and a relationship with God looks like.
It's a perfect day for the road. The blue sky will take us home. We'll take it easy, we'll take it slow. Good day for the road.
My first job was in a Catholic school. I was not Catholic. And my journey began with a group of grade 5 students teaching me about the Catholic faith. Shortly after that, I joined an RCIA program and began to explore that. And here I am 10 years in, and it's been one of the most wonderful journeys of my life.
From the moment you walk in the door, there is our patron saint, Saint Joseph. There are crucifixes, there are prayers on the walls, there are stations of the cross. In every single classroom, we have prayer centers. There is a Bible. There, if it's Advent, there are candles. We ensure that you're never far away from religion in any direction in this school.
It's such an inclusive environment that people can, no matter what faith background you are, that is respected and celebrated, and kids don't have to shy away from living their faith, whatever that might be, if it's an evangelical background or Catholic background or even any of the other world religions. They can be who they are and not feel that they have to hide that part of themselves.
It's a perfect day.
I come from a Mennonite background, so not Catholic background, but I find even though we don't agree on some standards, it's still an opportunity to challenge our own faiths, comparing others, yeah.
It's nice to kind of be able to come here and be able to kind of like be accepted too, and be able to practice my faith and not be like judged.
That is extremely important to me. I do believe in God, and I love learning about my faith.
Catholic education is a gift and a blessing. We are blessed to be funded within a public system.
As First Nations people, we're very compassionate. We're very spiritual. And many of our people rely on prayers first thing in the morning, and that's how they plan their day. And so if they can bring their kids to a school where they can openly share prayers and ask for help, you know, with families or staff to pray for everyone, that is so powerful for our parents, because there they know that they can openly share a prayer, and that's why it's so important for our children to learn the Lord's Prayer, all in the Blackfoot language.
In nom Omnipotens, Natura, Imitatum.
Prayer in its simplest form, and maybe even its most powerful form, is just having a conversation with God. We can do that in our Catholic system. We can help students recognize that it's really important to understand that there's a higher being. And then to generate a personal relationship with Jesus.
Dear God, we thank you for the privilege to go to school. We thank you for making sure that we are kind to everyone.
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
So in our schools, we help our students understand the importance of prayer in their life. So with our students, we look at experiencing prayer so that they will always understand that no matter what happens to them, no matter where they go in their life, God is with them.
I think prayer is the most obvious distinction between the public and the separate system, but it's what you do with the prayer and how you live out the prayer. St. Francis says it best when he says, preach the gospel by your lives, and if need, use words. So prayer is supposed to be how we live our lives, not just the prayers.
We start our day with song, and it's not just song, it's worship. It's praise and worship, and it really brings the hearts of the children up to God and their hearts up in prayer.
Father, I thank you for the measure of influence you have given me. With your help, I am going to use that influence to model a generous spirit. Help me, Father, to be a light in the darkness today. Amen.
It's a great thing to write. And you're writing, God loves you. Dear neighbor, I hope you are having a good day. God loves you. That's a great message. And how about in grade one and in all our grades at Father Leonard Van Tighem School, we permeate our Christian values and our virtues and our Catholic faith into everything we do. It's in our morning routine when we talk about the weather and how God gave us our earth and taking care of the earth. It's in how we interact with each other and how we speak to each other, how we play together, how we solve problems. It's totally integrated into everything we do.
Today we're going to be reading A Poison Tree by William Blake. So William Blake was...
I really think that religion and faith naturally infuses itself into the lessons. It's not something that you have to force. Those opportunities present themselves as learnable moments continually throughout the day and the subject matters.
Terrace on the Airline. I think the important thing about including faith in every aspect of our curriculum is that our gospel values aren't in just one aspect of our life. Our gospel values are in every aspect of our life. And those are the values that we need to not only learn about, but then also share those values with others and live by those values.
When we talk about being a human, okay, this is what Aristotle, then Aquinas, St. Thomas Aquinas, said what it means to be human. This is how you define one, okay?
The faith piece in learning, I think, gives them a base and a root understanding. So, not only are they looking at academics for the sake of academics, but it all goes towards this idea that God created everything and we are exploring his creation.
Okay. And anytime you violate one of these three, either to yourself or to another person or a society, that's what we would call sin from the Catholic point of view, or a violation of natural moral law. Okay?
It is not just a half hour or an hour a day of religious studies. Not at all. Math is infused with our Catholic tenets. Science, music, art, physical education, all of our courses are taught from a viewpoint of God is great, God is good.
So today our art project was to felt a rock using wool. And in order to do that and incorporate our faith, we decided to create a prayer rock. So the kids were able to incorporate the art form of felting and incorporate our faith into that project.
It is without question, Alberta Catholic Schools do a phenomenal job of teaching the program of studies. And then we infuse it and we mesh it with our understanding of what it means to be a person. How can we live out that value of love thy neighbor? And if we can come to that understanding as Albertans, if children come to that understanding of knowing everything that we want Alberta children to know and how that comes together in their development, boy, we're going to have a wonderful generation of Albertan children.
Thank you.
Catholic, right? Like, if you look at Ten Commandments, like, there's rules. Like, there's things you can't do, right? So when you're on the ice, if one referee says something, you don't swear at him, you have character, right? Coach hits you, you have character, you're disciplined, right? You'll sit, you don't talk back to him, right? You just know from being a Christian, from being Catholic, from learning from everything, right? From everything they teach you, take that on the ice and then help you.
We call it a vocation. Teaching is in Catholic education is a vocation, but maybe even stronger than that, it's a ministry. It's a calling to actually be that role model in the classroom of our faith.
As a teacher, you're a faith leader. At the end of the day, we're teachers. But as part of Catholic education, we're also spreading the good news.
Ultimately, I want the children to know that they are children of God and that their worth and their dignity comes from God. And I think when kids know that, they can allow themselves to relax and be free here to just learn and accept what God is giving them, the gifts that God is giving them through their education.
We chose St. Mike's mostly because it's kind of a continuation of our home life in the school system. The values that we like to live by at home are really evident here.
When parents tell us why they want their children to come here, they want to be in a faith-based public education system. They want their kids to be able to pray. They want them to learn about Jesus Christ. They want them to be surrounded by people who also share those same values.
So just the fact that faith was a component of it was a real plus for us. It wasn't a non-negotiable, but it's definitely been something that's an asset and something that we were eager to have him involved in.
When I worked in the public school, they were very clear that you can't talk about faith and you can't ask about faith. And if children start talking to you about faith, it's not my job to talk to them about their faith. It has to stay out of school.
In a public school, they focus more on the mind and the body. But when it comes to matters of faith, when it comes to matters that go beyond that, the Catholic school system allows for this more open discussion in matters of faith and morality as well.
That's part of your spiritual growth, is having that room to pray, having, being part of those, Christmas, Easter, like the whole Lent and Advent that lead up to those holidays prepares them. What is the meaning of it? Why is it, it's not materialism, it's your spirit.
All schools in Alberta are good schools. We have a great system. But in a Catholic school, you can question your whole being. You can question your spiritual side. You can immerse yourself into our Catholic faith. You can participate in it. But you're allowed to question that side of you and grow in your spiritualism.
As a family with five kids, our children have had challenges in their life, and during those challenges, I think it's the Faith Foundation that the education they've had the courage to bring those forward and express themselves as true Christians in their daily life.
Teachers have a certain experience and expertise in terms of teaching and pedagogy, and so they bring that gift. And when you bring it together with the understanding of the teaching of religion, I think you have the ability of a Catholic teacher to use their skill to convey the elements of our faith and to teach it in a way that is both exciting and also one that enriches the experience of a student learning.
My faith is stronger. I've lived it with children in this building. I've lived it personally. And I believe it, and I think it's the greatest gift you can ask to be involved in. And teaching children a faith in God that will be a stronghold for them, it doesn't get any better than that. music is always a gift, but I think music that speaks about God and the Lord and who He is a greater gift because it connects people to that wider spiritual side that a lot of people are missing out on.
I think we're very fortunate in Catholic education that we get the opportunity to educate the whole child, the mind, body, and spirit. And to eliminate one of those pieces would be a loss.
One of the things we have to recognize is the threat to Catholic education is louder than it's ever been before.
Yes, we're constitutionally protected, but so were other provinces who have since then lost Catholic education.
My fear of that is that we lose that faith aspect. That would be really difficult for me as a parent.
Where would it leave us? In my class, I like to constantly remind my students that, again, we should be thankful for things, we should treat people with dignity and respect. And we're like, well, why? Well, I have an answer right now. I say, because God loves that person just as much as He loves you.
Sometimes I think, you know, we have those people, and as we all know, it only takes one or two to stir the pot, and then, you know, other people jump on board.
In this day and age, of course there are going to be people who say it does not belong because they don't subscribe to the fundamental position that faith is an important developmental aspect for a child.
There's a belief out there that we're not as inclusive, and there's a belief out there that, you know, if we had only one system, we'd save all kinds of money. Not true.
I think something else about our Catholic schools is we've never been very vocal about us. Like, we've kind of been the quiet, well, I want to say the Catholic way. We aren't out there rah-rahing and door-knocking. And it's time that we become more vigilant about showcasing what we do and saying we are making a difference.
Well, GRACE stands for Grateful Advocates for Catholic Education. It's an advocacy group that's just formed in Alberta. And our goal is to create a conversation and awareness and advocacy about Catholic education. And I love the fact that it starts out grateful because we really are privileged to have fully funded Catholic education in the province of Alberta. And we recognize that gift.
I get the argument, I do. Why should the Catholics be allowed to have our own funded system? Well, I guess my first answer is, it works. It really works, and it's been working for over 100 years.
Catholic education in Alberta is growing. Each year, there's more students enrolled in our schools, and in most of our communities, each school is growing.
We're not only academically strong, we are faith strong. We are bringing children out of our high schools and out of our junior high and out of our elementary schools with skills that they can take, spiritual skills, that they can take forward into their new life.
So right now I'm in Walby and we made this cross for the school. Well, personally, I'm very proud of it. I mean, I'm glad that we're able to do lots of these projects like this for the school and just to give back.
It's nice to be able to like express my faith in different ways, especially just like in all our classes, so we can kind of try and infuse that into what we're doing.
We're sewing blankets in our sewing class, and then once we're done, everyone will bring their baby blanket to the hospital to use for the babies there who are in need of them, yeah.
You know, I'm a pretty hopeful individual, and I still would love to say that my grandchildren will be able to access Catholic education. And I've still got a strong belief that my grandchildren will. But it's going to take voices to be louder from the inside going out than from the outside coming in.
If you are a strong believer in Catholic education, share that in your community. I think it starts off writing your MLAs in support of Catholic education and choice of Christian education. And I mean, it sounds simple, but I think it is that simple.
I think the first thing we can do is be informed. And when the conversation comes up in our workplace or at the hockey rink or, you know, over coffee with a friend, be able to explain why you've chosen Catholic education, why it matters to you, and what you see as vital.
Catholic schools have a difference. They have a unique perspective on the world that I think our young people and our society need to constantly be reminded of. It recognizes the importance of the dignity of the human person and a commitment to the common good of society.
I think we've woken up. We need to, you know, we need to let the public become aware of what we do and how we do it.